सहनावतु सहनौनक सहवीर्यंकरवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः हरि हरि ॐ श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरि ॐ गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णु गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुर्विष्णु परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः वसुदेवसुतं देवं कंसचामूरमर्दनं देवी परमानन्दं कृष्णमन्दे जगद्गुरुं समस्तजनकल्याणे निरतं करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरम् भजन
जय गुरुदेवं चिन्मयानन्दं प्रणमाम्यहं गुरुदेवं अहर्निशं जय गुरुदेवं चिन्मयानन्दं प्रणमाम्यहं गुरुदेवं अहर्निशं प्रणमाम्यहं गुरुदेवं अहर्निशं धर्मोद्धारकं गीताप्रचारकं धर्मोद्धारकं गीताप्रचारकं आनन्दरूपं आत्मस्वरूपं आनन्दरूपं आत्मस्वरूपं जय गुरुदेवं चिन्मयानन्दं प्रणमाम्यहं गुरुदेवं अहर्निशं प्रणमाम्यहं गुरुदेवं अहर्निशं तामसहारकं उत्साहवर्धकं तामसहारकं उत्साहवर्धकं तपोवनशिष्यं तत्त्वस्वरूपं तपोवनशिष्यं तत्त्वस्वरूपं जय गुरुदेवं चिन्मयानन्दं प्रणमाम्यहं गुरुदेवं अहर्निशं प्रणमाम्यहं गुरुदेवं अहर्निशं प्रेमहृदयिनं परमविरागिनं प्रेमहृदयिनं परमविरागिनं सन्यासिनं गुरुं शिरसा नमाम्यहं सन्यासिनं गुरुं शिरसा नमाम्यहं जय गुरुदेवं चिन्मयानन्दं प्रणमाम्यहं गुरुदेवं अहर्निशं प्रणमाम्यहं गुरुदेवं अहर्निशं बोलिए श्री सद्गुरुनाथ महाराज की
You can come here. I'll be the one.
Go. You hear the echo.
Yeah, we'll have one more bhajan because after this meditation, so towards the end we are not able to have bhajans. So we have one more bhajan, then we start the class. By that time, everybody would also come.
Jesus
a new bhajan. Okay, Guruji, we are going to start a bhajan online from Chinmaya Mission. We are going to have an online bhajan class.
Yeah.
So this is the first bhajan we all are learning.
Oh, lovely, lovely. Uh-huh. Very good, very good, very good, very good.
Purushottamaya Rama Namo.
Purushottamaya Rama Namo.
Pavanaya Rama Namo.
So we have discussed all that has to be discussed on meditation. But today we will take some verses from mainly Gita and Upanishads and see how they have to be meditated upon. But before that, the one important meditation suggested by almost all people is the seer and the seen. Drug drishya viveka. Seer and the seen. Sarpon Maharaj also says Savikalpa Samadhi, Drushyanavidya, Shabdanavidya. Both are seer and seen, in fact. Our Gurudev also says that. And that is the easiest and common. Just watch your thoughts, watch your breathing. That's the first step. Second step, with a form, with a mantra, Aham Brahmasmi Tattvamasi. Every mantra is fully Vedanta only. Om Namo Narayanaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Bhagavate Vasudevaya. All of them are nothing but Advaitic concepts. We mechanically do it, but as Gurudev used to say, you will do it mechanically for a few years, but when you start doing, suddenly inquisitiveness comes in you. What does this mantra mean? And you start learning. You start learning. So all our mantras thus are nothing but Vedantic concepts. So one, you can just chant and see them. That is Rupanuvidha, Shabdanuvidha and all that. Another, understand and try to contemplate on the meaning and try to see its truth in yourself. The truth of what is said there in yourself. So we will now see that important aspect of seer and seen meditation. There is a complete book on this, also Drug Drishya Viveka. If you go to any meditation classes, first thing they say is watch your breath. That also comes under this. Watch your mind. All the time many people come and tell me it's very difficult, I'm not able to concentrate my mind, I am not able to control my mind. I say it's a great advantage. Because all that you have to do is just see the mind that you are not able to control. You are not able to control it, okay? It's going. Just watch it and be conscious of the one who is watching it. And that is Brahma. Simplest, you know. The one who is watching that flow, which you say you cannot control, is Brahman. You can't have a simpler meditation than that. Right. So now, let us see that text. Very interesting. Rupam drushyam lochanam druk tad drushyam druk manasam drushya dhi vrittayaha shakshi druge vana drushyate rupam drushyam, form is seen. Lochanam druk, seer is the eyes. Tad drushyam druk manasam, that is also seen. The seer becomes the mind. Drushya dhi vrittayaha, again the mind, the thoughts become the seen. Sakshi, the witnessing factor, becomes the seer, and that never becomes the seen. Again I repeat, very important this one, because I have not brought the entire textbook, this one, and then I will tell you the implications of that which is in that text. So you first try to understand this. It says, forms are seen. Eyes, seer. Eyes are seen. Mind is the seer. Mind is seen. The witness consciousness is the seer. That never becomes seen. That is the consciousness. What never becomes seen is the ultimate truth. In other words, what never becomes an object, that is the subject. The subject is the Atman. What never becomes an object is the subject. Subject is the Atman. Subject is the Atman. You can never become an object for yourself. You can become an object for others. You can never become an object for yourself. Now, object is always one. Subject is always one. Objects are many. Subject is always one. Objects are many. Even in the various our familiar examples, gold is one, cause. Effects are many. Gold is one. Effects are many. Water is one. Effects are many. Vacuum is one. Effects are many. Right? So, if you turn your attention from the many to the one, then all of them fuse into that one. And where there is no duality, that is the Brahmic state. That is one way of seeing it. Second thing is, we said eyes are the seer, mind is the seer at different stages, right? Now all problems belong to the seen. All problems belong to the seen. The problems of the seen never affects the seer. The problems of the seen never affects the seer. I see several problems. Eyes are not affected by that. Eyes itself have got andha, mandha, patutvam, blind, dull, strong. These are the various aspects of the eyes. They are blind, mandha, dull vision, patutvam, good vision, right? This becomes the scene for the mind. The eyes becomes the scene for the mind. The mind is not affected by the gunas of the eyes like andha, mandha, patutvam. Right? Mind itself is varied. Sankalpa, vikalpa, agitations. Right? Raga, dveshas. Several moods of the mind. The sakshi is the seer. The sakshi is not affected by the mind. Right? What I see, my eyes are not affected. What I see in the mind, in the eyes, my mind is not affected. What I see in the mind, I, the witness, is not affected. So by this simple meditation of seer and the seen, you can come to that which is free from all limitations and blemishes, right? After that, you only have to continuously suggest to yourself, wherever you are meeting a challenge, the challenge belongs to the BMI, OET. I am not the BMI, I am not the OET, I am the seer. BMI, OET are all seen, I am the seer. All problems belong to the seen, I, the seer, have no problem. Simple, effective meditation which can be practiced by everyone. This meditation can be practiced by everyone. Very simple, very practical. Right? The same thing, now our Tapavan Maharaj says in page 51 here. Yeah, 51, last two lines, then you have to turn 52. The last two lines, then you have to turn to 52. The Sat aspect of Brahman is unaffected by the three periods of time, the past, present, and future. Since I, the self, exists in the three states of existence, namely Jagrat, Swapna, Sushupti, and the three periods of time, I am Sat, pure existence. Similarly, since I am always illuminating all objects by constant awareness, I am Chit, pure awareness. Love in its most exalted form wells up from Ananda, bliss. I love myself more than the world of objects, body and sense organs. The body, the sense organs, and the world of objects become dear objects of love to me only in their relationship with myself. As I am the object of unsurpassed love, transcending all other objects in the world, I am also Ananda, the pure bliss. Before he comes to that seer scene, this itself, you know, Satchidananda. Satchidananda, one aspect. Second aspect. Why you love everything else? Because you love yourself most whole. Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, all he has condensed and in a language anybody can understand. That is the speciality of Tapovan Mara. You know, such a whole description of Sachidana. You just read it 4-5 times, you will understand clearly Sachidana. You can take a class on that. And then the most interesting topic in whole Grihadaranyaka Upanishad, Atmanastu Kamaya Sarvam Priyam Bhavati. That also he has done, finished here. Na Patyuk Kamaya Pati Priyam Bhavati, Na Jaya Kamaya Jaya Priyam Bhavati. Whole thing there. That also he has finished. Thus, the Sat Chit Ananda aspects of Brahman are also attributes of myself, the self, who is the witness of all the three states of existence. Who is the witness of all the three states of existence. That is, I am the seer. Can be easily identified as Brahman with the threefold attributes of existence, knowledge and bliss. It is not difficult for an average thinking person to arrive at this identification. Proper intellect and faith alone are necessary for this. Truth can be grasped with proper attention or sreddha, irrespective of whether one is a boy or an old man, an illiterate or a scholar, a sinner or a man of immense merit. This is the speciality of the Tapovan Mara. He makes everything simple and no qualifications needed. See, before I saw the answer, earlier I read, he's talking about seer seeing, but here specifically not mentioned. So again turn back to 51. And the Swami Tapovanam, the witness I, leave the first sentence because that we have already dealt. Take the second sentence. The changes in the object seen are attributed to the seer only through sheer illusion. If we examine thus, there is no difficulty in getting the firm conviction that I, the self, is only witness of the various experiences of the body and objects of the world outside and their favorable, unfavorable reactions in each of these states, waking dream and deep sleep state. The witness is the Atman described as Thou in the Mahavakya, Tattvamasi, that Thou art. So he's talking about the final seer as the witness. And he said, this is not affected by all the seen. He is the seer, not affected by all the seen. You must ask me, you are trying to drag it to suit your explanation of seer seen. But see the heading of that chapter. What is the heading of that chapter?
Seer
seen. So I'm not dragging. Okay, not guilty. Gurudev, page 22 of Art of Contemplation. The seer and the hearer, last para, in the 22, the hearer and the seer are something other than what is seen and what is heard. The seer and the hearer is something different other than what is seen and what is heard. The hearer is not singing, he is only hearing the sound. Then next para, you are he. When you have settled down quietly in your contemplation seat, you are seeing your body existing without any movement. Like the temple, you are hearing your mind chanting the mantra, you are the seer of the body and the hearer of the chanting of the mind. You are the seer of the body and the hearer. You are the subject. Your relationship with the body and the mind is exactly as your relationship with the distant temple and chanting when you are sitting under the tree. You were then something other than the temple, and you were certainly something other than the chanting and the chanters. We now recognize the same situation within ourselves. We keep the body without movement as the temple, and when the mind has become relatively quiet, we become conscious of the quietude. Quietude is also seeing. You are the seer of the quietude. Right? So, this is a simple meditation which anybody can do, and doing this one meditation is enough. You see, anything, if there is a buffet, right? Today's, I don't know here, in India, buffet means they will organize all sorts of foods. South Indian, North Indian, chat, continental, and Thai, all. If you take all, you will definitely next 4 days you don't have to eat. You choose what you like and eat. Here also, meditations are also buffet. Don't have to practice all. One simple thing what you can do, do it. This is a very simple thing. You can do it. Right? Then Upanishad. How to recognize this self, the seer, the subject? The very first question in Kena Upanishadam, Keneshitam patati preshitam manah kena prana prathama praiti yuktaha kena ishitam patati preshitam manah. Willed by whom, propelled by whom, the mind goes to their respective objects. Why should somebody be there to will the mind? Why there should be anybody? Mind can go. If the mind can go, why in sleep it doesn't go? Its nature is to go. Why in sleep it doesn't go? It's inert. Unless it is in contact with consciousness, it cannot function. Mind is inert. You are lucky. If mind is all the time active, not inert, you can't sleep. You can't sleep. Right? So the mind is one logic. Second logic. If the mind is totally independent, right? Is totally independent, there is no sadhana needed, no meditation needed. You can't do anything about it. You can't do anything about it. If you have total control over the mind, then why the mind doesn't think things that you don't like? Are you able to stop it? It runs as it likes, right? So therefore, mind runs, but you can control. Mind runs, you can control. How? There, you are different from the mind. That's all the point I want here. You are different from the mind. Right? So it is you that controls the movement of the mind, as they said. Kena ishitam patati preshitam manaha. Kena prana prathamai yuktaha. Then, how to know this Rasalila? Gurudev has given us these pointers. You don't get them in Bhagavata also. You have to only infer, but Gurudev has said it beautifully. In the Rasalila, first Krishna is in the center. All thoughts dance around the center. Then Krishna is seen between the two gopis, two thoughts. First, Krishna is the center, all thoughts go in circle. Next, Krishna is between the two gopis, two thoughts. The third stage, Krishna is with every gopi. Krishna is with every thought. Pratibodha viditam. This consciousness is seen with every thought. If you are experiencing a thought, consciousness is attached to it. Without that, you cannot see. Easy meditation. I am conscious of my thought. So therefore, consciousness plus thought. detached from the object, it's pure consciousness. Consciousness plus object is thought. Detached from the object, it's consciousness. Mind is consciousness. Thought is consciousness. If you detach from the object, difficult. This is another simple one. Difficult. I can't detach from the object. Make the object consciousness. Mind can always be attached to an object. So turn the mind, let the object be consciousness. Then what happens? Consciousness plus object is thought. Now consciousness plus object itself is consciousness. Therefore there is no thought. It's all consciousness. That is meditation. Turning inward, the mind discovers it's nothing but consciousness. In meditation, the mind has no other object other than consciousness. Then the mind discovers, I am nothing but the consciousness. Right? That is Keno Upanishad. Another beautiful thing, Keno Upanishad, series he gives. Yet chakshusha na pashyati, yena chakshumshi, yet chakshusha na pashyati, yena chakshumshi pashyati. That which cannot be seen by the eyes, because of which the eyes see. That which is not seen by the eyes, but because of which the eyes see. Right? Consciousness cannot be objectified, seen by the eyes. But without the consciousness, you cannot see. Merely repeating this mantra won't help. As you are repeating, feel that because of which the consciousness, not so difficult, just needs your cooperation. All these meditations are very simple. Only if you bring your heart at the time of meditation to what you are contemplating. Don't have to bring it all the time. 5 minutes. Take one mantra. Take just one mantra. 5 minutes with all your heart. See what it says. What is it that I cannot see, but because of which my eyes see? You can feel the consciousness. Not so difficult. Not at all difficult. Right? So all these meditations are simple. We always say difficult, difficult, difficult because our heart and pagoda doesn't come here. That's all. 5 minutes you are not able to bring your heart from the pagoda. And the heart, and the Bhagavan consciousness says, if your mind doesn't come from pagoda to him, he says, poikoda. And same thing, Kratopanishad says, same thing. In fact, I cheat a lot of people. When I take Kratopanishad, this mantra comes. This is complete Keno Upanishad. So when I chant this mantra, in one class I finish Keno Upanishad saying that this is what it says. So they listen Katha Upanishad, they get bonus Keno also. Because it's only one class when you do this. What is consciousness? How to know it? Lovely words. Even if you don't know Sanskrit, you can enjoy the words. Yena, Rupam, Rasam, Gandham, Shabdam, Sparshamcha, Maitunan, Yetaina, Eva Vijanati. By which you can know the rupa, form, rasa, taste, gandham, smell, shabdam, sounds, sparshan, touch, maitunan, the man-woman relationship, Yetaina, Eva Vijanati. By which you know all these things. By which you know all these things, that is the Atman. That is the Atman. Keno Upanishad. This is Katha Upanishad. Another thing in Katha Upanishad, this is the main question put in a different form second time. First time in the Katha Upanishad, Nachiketa says, Yeyam Prete Vichikista. But Yamadharmaraja is avoiding that. So after some time he puts the same question in a different way. Listen, this is a very important thing. You are getting all bonus of listening to Katho and Keno Upanishads also now. Free. Right? Anyatra dharmat, anyatra adharmat, anyatra krutat akrutatcha, yet tat pashyasi tat vada, anyat bhutatcha bhavyatcha, that also is there. That which is different from dharma adharma, that which is different from past and present, that which is different from cause and effect, that which is different from cause and effect, that is the self. Is that simple? You tell me, I will explain. You tell me it is simple or not. That which is different from dharma, adharma, means what? That which shows you dharma and adharma, neither it is dharma nor adharma, that which supports both these thoughts, dharma, adharma, but that which is neither dharma or adharma, that which supports past and present, but which is neither present or past, that is, it's not time, but it shows you the time, the variations of time, right? And that which is neither the cause nor the effect, because they are also relative. In our parallel, whatever we cause, cause and effect are also relative, because that is called uncaused cause. The ultimate is called uncaused cause, right? Cause is gunas, vasanas. Effect is this body. Both are illumined by the self. It is neither the cause, vasanas, gunas or the body, right? It illumines cause and effect, vasanas, this body. What illumines everything? Vasanas in sleep, they are dormant, that alone is there, right? It is this consciousness. It just needs a little turning inside and feeling it. Not intellectually understanding, feeling it. That's all meditation. That's all meditation. Oh. Mundaka Upanishad, with what we did here. Yatta dreshyam agotram, agotram avarnam achakshuhu srotram asrotram apanipadam, which cannot be seen, which has no lineage, which cannot be heard, which has no color, that from which all thoughts emerge, bhuta yoni, that from which all thoughts emerge, that is the self. Self cannot be seen, has no color, no lineage. But how to know it? From which all thoughts are emerging? That is the self. Is this so difficult to see where from thoughts rise? Because if you say, I can't control the thoughts, difficult. Who asked you to control? Just see where from they are rising. That is you. That is you. Why then meditation is so difficult? You have assumed several things. That's all. You have assumed several things. You have assumed meditation means concentration. There should not be thoughts. I should stop the mind. These are all your assumptions. These are all your assumptions. Then, this is seer seeing. Then there is one more, possessor, possessed. Possessor, possessed. Whatever you possess, you are not. Whatever you possess, you are not. When you possess, you say, my. You are I. I is the possessor. Everything else is possessed. Right? My house cannot be me. My car cannot be me. You are so dear, my wife, but still cannot be you. My child cannot be you. And some people may not agree. My dog cannot be me. Because identification with the dog is so strong. Right? My dog cannot be me. My body cannot be me. My mind cannot be me. My prana cannot be me. My intellect cannot be me. Then who? What is this? Who is telling my body, my mind, my intellect? Who is witnessing the body, mind and intellect? That is you. Is it so difficult? All these things are not difficult. Difficult because you have no love for what you are doing. Love is invested outside and you are not able to bring it back. Right? That's all. All these meditations are very, very, very simple, provided you bring your love from the wrong investment to here. That is why all the Upanishads say, ultimate knowledge is felt in the heart. Knowledge should be felt in the intellect. But all of them say, hrudi. It's felt in the heart. Because the heart has gone outside. When the heart comes back, you can feel it. When the heart comes back, you can feel it. So that is, I have explained, but I will say Sanskrit also because it's so beautiful to listen, right? You may not understand, but it's beautiful. You may understand also if you just apply a little, because all Indian languages have a lot of Sanskrit. Madhiyam shariram, madhiya pranaha, madhiyam manaha, madhiya buddhi, madhiyam agnanam iti svenaiva jayate tadyatha kataka kundala gruhadivat swasmad bhinnam bhavati. Madhiyam shariram, my body, madhiya pranaha, my pranas, madhiyam manaha, my mind, madhiya buddhi. Congratulations all women, feminine gender, buddhi. Manaha is masculine gender, right? My intellect, madhiya magnanu, my ignorance, iti svenaiva jayate, these things by whom they are seen, kataka kundala gruhadivat, like the bangles, kataka, kundala, gruhadivat, swasmad bhinnam bhavati. All these things, kataka, kundala, gruhadi, my house, my bangles, my ear, swasmad, from you, they are different. From you, they are different. Madhiyatvena jnatam, whatever is known as madhiyatvam, mine, pancha koshadikam, all these five koshas, swasmad bhinnam bhavati, different from you. Madhiyatvena jnatam, atmana bhavati, whatever is known as mind can never become the self. Madhiyatvena jnatam, atmana bhavati. Okay, so that is possessor and possessed. Enough, seer seem over, possessed over. That's all you have to do, right? Then, Kaivalya Upanishad, because Gurudev's favorite, six verses, but I will do only one, right? I won't do everything. Because Balaji said, 8:15 today, if you don't close, right, you will be sent out. He said, we have some other programs, your time is over at 8:15. Right? Yat param sarvatma vishvasya ayatanam mahat sukshma sukshmataram nityam tad brahma iti avadharayet. You are that Brahman. Yet Param, that which is highest. Param means highest. What is Param? What is the highest?
Supreme.
What is the highest? How do you say Param? That which lasts long. When the others gone, if it is still there, that is Param. That is Param, Supreme. What is it that lost when everything is gone? Body gone, mind gone, intellect gone, object gone, emotions gone, thoughts gone, existence exists. That existence is the supreme, ultimate, most, and that you are. One indication. These are all called tattvastha lakshanas. Take something that changed, and through that you explain the changeless. Take something that is known, through that you explain the unknown. This is called tattvastha lakshana. Yet Param, that which is beyond all finite things, changing things, the existence, that you are, Sarvatma, the very core of all beings. Existence is the core of all beings. Further, how to know that? Vishvasya Ayatanam, that is the abode of all the changing names and forms. The existence is the abode, support of all changing names and forms. Mahat, the greatest. Sukshma, Sukshmataram. Sukshma, Sukshmataram. Subtler than the subtlest. What is subtle? That which occupies more space is subtle. Ice is gross. Ice, when becomes water, occupies more space. Not as easily seen as the ice. That which is not easily seen, that which occupies more space, is subtle. Ice is gross, water is subtle. Water is gross, vapor is subtle. Right? If you continue this argument, what is that which is the subtlest? Means what? Which is everywhere. Which is everywhere, which is not seen. Existence. Right? So that is the way to contemplate these verses. Not mechanically repeat. Yet Param, that which is the highest. Sarvatma, the very core of all beings. Sukshma, Sukshmataram, subtler than. Nothing happens. You have to see the truth of it in yourself while contemplating. That is called meditation. Whatever you are reading, whatever you have understood, it has to be felt in you. That's called meditation. And my favorite is always Bhagavatam. How much we have talked now about this. Bhagavatam simplifies. Hitva anyarupam, discarding all forms, swaswarupena, staying in your own being. Whatever form you see, that's not Atman. What is left is Atman. Simplest definition. Bhagavatam is the highest. You want to know what is Atman? Simplest. I'm not going into that. Don't be scared. I'm not going into Maya. All things, total clarity and simplicity, not ambiguous, is Bhagavatam. So now, Gita. The best in Gita is in the 8th chapter, Kavim Purana Manushasitaram. That is the best meditation. Chant, it's nice. Kavim Purana Manushasitaram. Anoraniyam samanusmaredyah.
Anoraniyam samanusmaredyah.
sarvasya dataram achintya rupam
sarvasya dataram achintya rupam
aditya varnam tamasah parastat
aditya varnam tamasah parastat
kavim that which knows all omniscient omniscient kavi is not a poet who just changes the order of the words and it becomes poetry today, modern language, right? You just change the order of the words and it becomes poetry. That's not Kavi. Ka means Brahman. Kavi means one who knows Brahman. Therefore, omniscient. Therefore, omniscient. Kavim, right? Who is the omniscient in you? Who knows everything? All happened in you. Childhood, middle age, all that has happened in you, who knows completely, is the self, omniscient. Puranam, most ancient, how ancient, what is the most ancient? That which was before time is most ancient. When does time come? Time comes with the second experience. First experience, there is no time. Think. You don't have to agree what all I say. Just think. Can there be time without the second experience? Time comes with the second experience. Therefore, as the unit of time is called second. This is all Gurudev's this thing. Right? Time comes with the second experience and therefore the unit of time is called second. Therefore, at the first experience, what was there? Can there be nothing? If the second has to have first, there it cannot be nothing. What was there? The very origin of time. What is that? Existence, consciousness. From that, first experience comes, second experience comes, time comes. That which is the very origin of time is the most ancient, and that is existence consciousness, that is you. Merely saying existence consciousness, so what for me? My problems are remaining. No, sir, you are that existence consciousness, sir. Right? My problems are remaining. So, sir, you have already identified with the body. Therefore, you are saying my problems are remaining. The body, because it is a product of time and space, ages. That which was not a product of time and space, which is the very origin of time and space, never ages. And hence no change, hence no problem. So what, when you say my problem, you are misplacing your identity with your servant, the body. And then you say my problem. Body, mind, intellect, objects, emotions, thoughts are your servants given by Lord for you to enjoy. But you have made them your masters, pay for it. Anushashitaram, next. The one who governs all functions in you. The one who governs all functions in you. I see because of that. Ears hear because of that. You breathe because of that. The one who governs all activities in you. Anushashitaram. Sarvasya dhataram. That which supports all. That which supports all. What supports all? Your existence and consciousness. That is what supports everything. There also Kaivalya we saw Vishwasya Ayatanu, that which is the abode, support. What supports all ornaments? Gold. What supports all waves and bubbles? Water. The essential being in any manifestation is that which supports it. The cause is what supports all effects. The cause is Satchidananda Brahman. That supports all of you. Right? And that is you. So you have enough hints now to meditate. take any verse from Gita, take any verse from Upanishad. This is the way to contemplate. Right? You now do your own homework. Right? You do your own homework. I just gave you hints. Right? So we stop here because before Balaji shouts at us. So
we have 15 minutes. 15 minutes.
No, we'll do the meditation. We do the meditation. Today we do the Panchakshari. As I said earlier, the focus should be on the silence between the two chantings. The chantings are given to us to help us to identify the silence between the two mantras. The mantras are secondary compared to the silence in the seat of meditation. But for contemplation, mantras become important. We have seen elaborately what is Omkara earlier. Yesterday we did Ashtakshari Om Namo Narayanaya. That means I bow down, I prostrate to that abode, the goal of all human beings. What is the abode of all? What is the goal of all? Total happiness and total security. That is Narayana, Narasya Ayanam. And today we shall see the Panchakshari which says, Namas Shivaya. I bow down to that auspiciousness. Shiva, auspicious. What is auspicious? That which never dies. What is it that never dies? Atman. In both Namo Narayanaya and Namah Shivaya, Namaha is there. What is that? I bow down. What do you mean by I bow down? I surrender my sense of individuality, identification with the BMI, the ego, on the understanding that they are all nothing but Narayana and Shiva. That is called Namah Shivaya. Surrendering the ego at the altar of the totality or godhood. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Purnamidam Purna Purnamudashyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate Om Shanti 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 Harihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om. See this japa chanting, it should be basically done with the mind silent. Because if you do it loudly, it can become mechanical. Mind can wander. When you do it mechanically, Namah Shivaya, Namah Shivaya, you can be chanting Namah Shivaya, Namah Shivaya, but mind can wander. But when you do it with the mind, mind cannot wander. Because when you chant Om Namah Shivaya, the mind is with that thought. The mind, however fast it is, can at one time be with one thought. So therefore, this has to be done mentally. But since at the beginning stage, we cannot straight go to the silence, mentally chanting, you can a few chantings do loudly, then gradually reduce and go to the silence and chant mentally. One thing. Second thing, if your mind is very turbulent, you can also vary the speeds to make it silent. Loud, fast, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah. These are all the various techniques to suit each individual. He has to decide how he can become bring the mind to quietitude and chat on the silence. Okay. So, this all. And I've been here for 15 days, and this time it is Sadhguru's grace. I had not only participated in this class, I have also visited and had the opportunity to meet a few other classes. Dubai is too impressive. Bali Vihars are too strong. First, I think she is the origin of all that. Of course, now there are several people, but everything I think because the pioneer began, and now, of course, there are plenty of people. Bali Vihars are too strong. Kavita, Harini, Karuna. These are the few people I have seen, but of course she is also doing. No, there are several others, and each one of them, the names I said, are guiding 10 or 12 people. These names, what I said, Kavita, Harini and all, they are not merely conducting Bali Vihars. They are also guiding 10 or 12 people, each one having 20 students. Amazing figures for this small place. Amazing figures, and they are too good. Study groups equally. There is a study group which is going for 32 years. Another group started by Balaji. Another group she is conducting at her house. I think this is not known to many people. She herself is conducting a class there. And now June 9th is fixed for Harini's class. And we see potentiality to start classes in Kavita's, by Kavita for study group, and to Karuna also, potentialities. Yuva Kendra, tremendous potentiality. I have seen, though there is no organized Yuva Kendra meeting to me, already I have seen quite a lot of people, all are very promising. But this place is too good, bubbling with activity. These one or two things also you can probably think over and do, right? I'm so happy I came here, right? And I had satsang. One more thing I want to tell you. I have, in these four or five places, I have met 100 people. Average 25, you keep it. Here, Kavita's place, Harini's place, that Karuna's place, and in your place, around 100 people. It is sheer Gurudev's grace. None of them assert their personality, all of them are tuned to the cause. There is no ego felt by me, at least. I saw everybody is beautiful, working towards a cause. That is something amazing. I met 100 people, all of them are like that. Very amazing. I'm so happy. And I think the credit should go to the silent motivator who doesn't interfere, Mr. Jayaraman. Narayan. Right? Thank you all. God bless you. 5 minutes, minute, close panta. Because I don't want to take the risk of you saying, shut up. Right? Yeah. I think now there is some other program you can conduct. If you want me to go to the other side, I... Okay, Narayan.